believe. We still believe. We still believe.
Mayor, what do you want to say to your friends?
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you.
I appreciate it. We still believe. Mayor, what do you want to say to everybody here today?
We love you, Mayor.
You're right. Mayor, can you offer a comment at all to all the supporters that are here for you? Mayor, have you considered resigning at all, Mayor? Has that been a consideration?
The indictment was read to my client. We entered a plea of not guilty. We waived the full reading of it because we had it since Friday. The judge then set a scheduling order for date for motions to be filed, a motion argument date. Certainly motions are going to be filed in this case, and we will certainly be arguing motions. In the interim, we'll receive, I would assume, you know, a good amount of discovery, which the DA will start sending to us through their portal or through an external hard drive within the next 40 days or so.
We have nothing against Judge Leone. I've appeared in front of him before. He's a very fair judge, but to step outside this county without consulting the defense team or anybody on the defense side, I thought was improper.
We have a 2-count indictment here today, and without getting into too many details, as this is a pending trial, it's a scheme to defraud based upon the political action committee and circumventing campaign finance law by doing that through a political action committee.
So underrepresenting donations, or what does that mean?
Circumvention, so the election law dictates that there's a certain amount for each and every campaign. In this case, it was for the mayoral campaign from 2013 through 2017 election cycle, and by law, that was set at $8,557. The scheme that has been alleged here through the indictment is that trying to use a political action committee to circumvent that amount and go beyond that amount.